Now let us start new chapter, chapter 5. The name of the chapter is data handling, looking for information. Children, you have seen in the newspaper and news channel and weather graph, you all aware about it, the record for the population from 1999 to till now. So how we show for those all things in the practical life, we show by the data handling. So looking for information, you can see here in our day to day life, you might have come across information such as runs made by batsmen in the last 10 test matches. So comparison, why we need the datas, according to the help of datas we can compare easily. Because when we compare in the book, we will write it time consuming. So when we draw any figure or any rectangle type or graph type things, easily we can compare. Okay, the number of wickets taken by a bowler in the last 10 ODIs, mark scored by the a student of your class in the mathematics unit test, suppose that periodical test you have completed, and numbers also we will give you, definitely we will tell you, and in the unit test 1, and I want to compare about your number. So how many students they are getting 20 numbers, how many students those who are getting 10 numbers. So I will rough that, I'll prepare, and if anybody is telling me, so with the help of graph easily I can tell. Okay, then number of story books read by each of your friends, it's the information collected in all such cases is called data. Data is usually collected in the context of a situation that we want to study. Suppose that I want to study about your unit test first, so I'll collect the first data. Okay, for example, a teacher may like to know the average height of the students in her class. To find this, she will write the heights of all the students in her class, organize the data in a systematic manner. The meaning of the systematic manner, this in the increasing height or decreasing. Okay, suppose that any student is having 153 centimeter height and other students is having 140 centimeter, other is having 132. So in this way, if it is the rough data I have collected, now I will arrange in either in the increasing order or decreasing order. So it is called a systematic manner. And then interpret it accordingly. Sometimes data is represented graphically to give a clear idea of what it represents. Do you remember the different types of graphs which we have learned in the earlier classes? In the earlier classes, that means like small classes, like third standard and fourth standard, you have drawn this type of pictograph. This called pictograph. In the sixth standard also. So sometimes data is represented graphically. Okay, a pictograph, pictorial representation of data using symbols. So symbol we are using here, one car is equal to 100 cars. So one symbol stands for 100 cars. So July, in the month of July, 100 cars, and half, that means 50. So 250 cars. In the month of August, 3 full cars, that means 300 cars. In September, 4 full cars, that means 400. How many cars were produced in the month of July? Easily you can say. In which month were maximum numbers of cars produced? In the September. Easily you can see with the help of pictograph. And the number of the cars? 400. Okay. Now next is bar graph. A display of information using bars of uniform width, their heights being proportional to the respective values. Now see here, a display of information, you can see years are written here and data we are taking on this, number of students of class 8 and 2000. Uniform width, you can see width 0 to 1 and leave one space, one square box, then one square box, you can see Here we are not taking or changing the gaps here. So it should be like this. Their heights being proportional to the respective values, heights and academic years. Bar heights give the quantity for each category. Okay. Bars are of equal width with equal gaps in between. Equal width. Width also you can see and gap also. Now what is the information given by the bar graph? The information given by the bar graph is number of students in class 8th in the different years. In which year the increase in the number of students maximum? So here is one box, difference one box, and difference one box. But here you can see two box. So from 2003, that means in 2004 and 5 is the year the number of students maximum comparatively to previous. In which year is the number of students maximum? State whether true or false. The number of students during 2005-6 is twice that 2003-4. So 2003 and 4 the number of students 100. Then 200. 100 to the 200. Yes. So you will solve this in your notebook also. Describe first bar graph and then. Okay. Now next you can see double bar graph. A bar graph showing two sets of data simultaneously. It is useful for the comparison of the data. You can see here the blank bar we are using for year 2005-6 and shaded. That means black bar we are using for year 2006-7. Here marks obtained by a student in 2000, a student. So students marks we are comparing in 2005, 2006 and 7 session. What is the information given by the double bar graph? So the information given by the double bar graph is marks obtained by a student in the year 2005-6 and 2006-7. Okay. In which subject has the performance improved the most? In maths subject, performance improved the most. In 2005-6, he or she is getting 30 only in maths and then 60. In which subject has the performance improved the most? Done. In which subject has the performance deteriorated? So, in which subject? See here, deteriorated. That means bar graph is here. In the English subject, the performance deteriorated. In which subject is the performance at par? Equal. So, in Hindi. And deteriorated, that means the bar graph is showing poor performance comparatively the previous year. Okay. Start from the page number 71. If we change the position of any of the bars of a bar graph, would it change the information being conveyed? Why? So now you will think and you will reply. Definitely you will reply. I will be waiting for you. Okay. On my personal number. Try this. Draw an appropriate graph to represent the give information. Month, number of watches sold, July, August, September, October, November, December. And children who prefer school A, school B, school C, walking and cycling. School A. And percentage wins in ODI by 8 top cricket teams. This. So in this, you will draw double bar graph in this way. Clear? So what you will do, and here the single month you will take horizontally on the x-axis, and on the y-axis you will take number of watches sold. And what you will do for interval, you can take 500 500. So 500 500 interval you will take here, horizontally line, here vertical line, and 500 500 500 interval you will take, and you will draw this. Okay, now this walking, cycling. Okay, school A, school B, and school C. So data you will 10, 20, 30, 50. Okay, and walking and cycling. Walking, cycling, and this way you will draw the bar graph. Okay, percentage wins in this year. Double bar graph. South Africa, horizontally you will take here, and there the percentage you can take 10, 10, 10, 10 interval and try to do. Okay, now next is organizing data. So organizing data, it is called art, mathematics, different subjects list you can see. So it is called raw data, rough data. Okay, that means kacha material you can see. It is, you can see, not arranged in the systematically. Now systematically if we arrange, so according art, English, maths, and tally marks we know. Four vertical line and four vertical line cross one slanting line in shape. That is called tally marks. So when you will arrange subject art, tally marks, so number of students 7, mathematics 5, so you will get, it is called frequency, how many times the art subject is repeating, and it is called frequency, number, and grouping, the organizing the data in the systematic way. Frequency gives the number of times that a particular entry occurs. You can see frequency, tally marks, particular number, that means 7 students, those who have taken art subject. Now question based on, and frequency gives the number of times, already I explained you. Now you can see frequency distribution table, it is called frequency distribution table. Now try this, a group of students were asked to say which animal they would like most as a pet. The results are given, see here. So in this way you will pet animals, yeah, animals, tally marks, and number of people, and you will frequency distribution table you will do. Okay, now next is grouping data. Now in the grouping data you can see we are taking one example. Consider the following marks obtained in mathematics by 60 students of class 8. So that means class, in the class 8, 60 students marks in maths subject are written here. Now so many data, so with the help of a frequency distribution table, if we will, so large data we will get. So for this what we will do, we will fix one interval. Okay, so you can see this table. First we will find from here marks. So smallest number is 10, seven is the smallest, and greatest maximum out of 50. So till 50 we can take interval. So 0 to 10, 10 to 20 interval. It is called lower limit, upper limit, lower limit, upper limit, lower limit, upper. In this table we have arranged the data in the grouped form, you can see. So grouped frequency distribution, 0 to 10 one group. Most of the students have scored between 20 to 40. You can see here. Easily you will be knowing each of the group, that means is called class interval. Class interval, class interval. And lower class limit, upper class limit, already I told you. And the difference between these two, that means difference. Everywhere the difference is सेम. सो इट इज कॉल्ड विड्थ और साइज ऑफ द क्लास इंटरवेल. सो विड्थ और साइज ऑफ द क्लास इंटरवेल इज दिस 10. Now study the following frequency distribution table and answer the following questions. Frequency distribution of daily income. So you will do in this way. You have to prepare only. Okay. So half of the table on the next page. So you can do easily. Now see here. What is the size of the class interval? Everywhere the class interval, the difference is everywhere 25. So size 25. So 25 is the size of the class interval. Which class has the highest frequency? You can observe 140. So class this, and which class has the lowest? So smallest number you will frequency. You will check what the upper limit of class interval. Upper limit is 275. Lower limit is this. Which two classes have the same frequency? You can observe the table and you can do. Now you can see another bar with a difference. Class interval frequency. Now you can see here there is no gain in the bars, and there is no gap in the after 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 in this way. Okay, and here is no gap. You can see. So. On the horizontal axis, the height of the bar shows the frequency of the class interval. There is no gap between the bars and there is no gap between the class interval. The graphical representation of data in this manner is called histogram. Now, another histogram. So, in this histogram, you can see that jagged line. And jagged line, that means broken line, has been used along the horizontal line to indicate that we are not showing the numbers between 0 to 20. Because here you can see equal interval. Plus 5, plus 5, plus 5, plus 5, plus 5, plus 5, plus 5. But here directly 0 to 20. That's why we are showing this jagged line. That means 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15. That interval we are not taking here. Edges of 25 teachers of school. The range is divided in equal intervals of 5 years. You can see age in years and number of teachers we are showing. Bars of equal width with no gaps in between. Height of bar gives the number of data items in a particular group and is the frequency. Two teachers whose age between 40 to 45. Now from the bars of the histogram, we can answer the following questions. How many teachers are of age 45 years or more but less than 50 years? 2. How many teachers are age of less than 35 years? Less than 35? 6, 5, 11, 15. Observe the histogram and answer the questions below. Jagged line, we are not showing the interval between number between 0 to 1 to 4. What information is being given by the histogram? You will find, you can see here, which group contains maximum girls. This you will and write. Now, how many girls have a height of 145 centimeters and more? If we divide the girls into the following three categories, how many would there be in each? So, easily you can observe the with the help of histogram and you can solve this sums. Now we will start exercise 5.1. You can see here, sorry, for which of this would you use in a use a histogram to show the data? The number of letters for different areas in a postman's bag, the height of competitors is an athletics meet, the number of cassettes produced by 5 companies, the number of passengers boarding trains from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. at a station. Give reasons for it. So see here, the numbers of letters for different areas in a postman's bag. Okay, number of letter, different areas, but any criteria is given, interval is given, fixed, no. The height of a competitors in an athletics meet. So any athletics meet, when you will observe, you can take the interval. okay, and you can draw and draw a histogram. The number of cassettes are produced by 5 companies. अब in this what you can see 5 companies. So the number of cassettes, interval fixed, not given. The number of passengers here also given, definite. So in B and D, for these we can draw histogram. But you can see the number of letters for different areas in a postman's bag, and the number of cassettes produced by. So in this A and C, no need to draw a histogram, but in this two we can show with the help of histogram. Now the shoppers who come to departmental store are marked as a man, woman, W, boy, capital B, and girl for stands capital G. The following list gives the shoppers who came during the first hour in the morning. Okay, so the following list gives the shoppers who came during the first hours in the morning. So what you will do first here, data M, W, B, G, then tally mark, then frequency. Okay, after that you will get criteria, then what you will do, frequency distribution. After getting frequency distribution table by using draw bar graph, so you can draw bar graph horizontal line. What you will take, man, woman, boy, girl, and vertical on the x axis what you will take, 10, 20, 30, or 5, 10, any interval you can take, because interval is not defined here. Now the weekly wages of 30 workers in a factory are in rupees. Some are getting 830 rupees, 890, okay. Using tally marks, make a frequency distribution table. That means same way, what we will write on the vertical lines, interval we have to take 800 to 810, 810 to 820, in this way. First is 0. On the vertical line you will take, and on the horizontal line 30 workers. Okay, so workers, wages in rupees, workers. So you will get, after when you will get idea, when you will form a distribution table, frequency distribution table. Draw a histogram for the frequency table made for the data in question number 3. Okay, and answer the following questions. So on the basis of this you have to draw an histogram also. So we'll solve third question. Okay, now in third question you will solve in this way: class intervals, daily marks, and frequency between 800 and 810. 3 workers, those who are getting between these rupees. This way you will, maybe my table may be wrong, but see here, cross check you can do in this. 30 workers we are getting. So first you will count and you will do. Maybe here I am also human being, so I make mistake. So you will count and you will do. I am giving you a only idea. Okay, I am not telling it is wrong, but it is so small things you have to count and you have to write. Okay, so in this way you can give. Clear? Now on the basis of this we will draw histogram. For this chapter you will make a graph notebook. Now you can see here, on the basis of the third question, because we got in the third question frequency distribution table, so on the basis of that I have drawn the histogram. You can see weekly wages in rupees and number of workers. Now see here, in which interval maximum number of workers. So number of workers you can see in the between this interval, that means rupees 830 and rupees 840, in this 830 to 840, number of workers are 9. Now second question, in second question number of workers, those who are getting more than at 50. So 1 plus 3 plus 1 plus 1 plus 4. 3, 1, 4, 4, 2, 6, 4, 10. You will write your answer in the complete statement. Number of workers, those who are getting more than at 50 rupees is equal. Dash plus dash plus dash plus dash plus equal. Now number of workers, those who are getting less than at 50. You can see here 3 plus 2 plus 1 plus 9 plus 5. 20. So answer you can see here, but in the, I have not written in the statement form, but you will write in the statement form. Is it clear? Now in the fifth question, you can see the number of hours for which students of a particular class watched television during holidays is shown through the given graph. Okay, answer the following. For how many hours did the maximum numbers of students watch TV? You can see the. Because here jagged line, because interval, proper interval we have taken 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3. Okay, so you can, this question you can do yourselves. Okay, your work should be neat.